Hello everyone, this is Rashi Razdan from Algoji. If you can hear my voice, just type yes in the chat box so that we can proceed. Okay, thank you so much. So today we are going to talk about discovering great strategies for Indian markets, and this is part one. So we have split this particular webinar in three parts. Today we'll be covering just part one, which is we are going to talk about strategies for TradingView, and in the coming webinars we'll talk about strategies for MT4, AmiBroker and Excel. So this is the fourth webinar of our webinar series. Initially, we covered what and why of system-based trading. Then we covered free tools for system trading. The last webinar was about tool comparison for algo trading. And today, it is about discovering great strategies for Indian market. Or you can say, I'll be telling you about strategies so that you can get started with algo trading. Let's move on. And I would like to tell you about trade plan. So you must have noticed that in each of my webinar, I tell you about trade plan. So there must be something important about it, because if I'm emphasizing on a trade plan, then it must be important for you as a trader to prepare one. So trade plan is what? It gives you set of rules. So what you do in a trade plan, you just write your set of rules so that you have something, you have a framework to evaluate your performance. You have your rules written in a document, and you will be following these rules. So you can see, I have created a template here. You can also prepare a similar template trade plan for yourself. So here I mentioned trading style, trade timing, my trading capital, and pre-market routine to time frame to entry criteria, exit criteria, my risk capacity, order management, execution plan, and in the end I've also mentioned evaluate your actions. So you can evaluate your trades and profits and or losses at the end of day, week or month, whichever is suitable to you. So you require a trade plan, you require rules, you require your strategies to work upon when you are trading with algo or you are trading with system. So this is how you can prepare your trade plan. Now we'll move ahead, and I'll give you a quick recap of what we talked about in the first webinar. So these are the four major components of system-based trading. The first one is buy and sell logic, next is risk management, and then order and slippage management and position management. So why I'm mentioning this again and again? Because these four components make up your trade. Each of these components are important for you to make your trading profitable and to minimize your risk. And foundation of any trade is the first component, which is buy and sell logic. You need a buy and sell logic to build upon, and each component has its importance. When you see all these components and pieces, they won't mean much, but when you put all of them together, then they can be of great value to you. They can maximize your profit. So whole is greater than sum of parts. Things are together than what we see in pieces. And now, let's move on, and I'll come to free strategy resources. Win and loss ratio. What is win and loss ratio? Average money made in winning trades. The money you make in winning trades upon the average money you lose in losing trades. So you can see here we have plotted this graph. So here we have win percentage, or what you commonly call as accuracy. So accuracy here is 20%, 30% and 80%. It is plotted till 80%. And here win loss ratio is still 6 points. Now, here is the break-even line, and at this point it is profitable, and this point it is unprofitable. Now let's see. So in if we see win percentage, the accuracy of here accuracy is 20%. What is the win loss ratio? Win loss ratio at this point will be around 4.5, and here you can see accuracy is 70%, and in this particular case win loss ratio will be around 0.4 or 0.5. so what does this mean? Now you can see here the accuracy is more, but the win ratio is very less. But here accuracy is very less, but win by loss ratio is more. So if average money made in a winning trade is large, if the average money made in a winning trade is large, this does not guarantee that the number of winners are more. So here the average money made in winning trade is very large, but the number of winners are only 20%. But then if money lost in losing trades is too high, so if you are losing money, if the money lost in losing trades, the money you lost in losing trades is very high, then maybe the ones who lost were very few, because they lost very heavy amount. Now we'll come back to the slide, and again a question for you. So system A has a win loss ratio of 3/10, and it makes more money than system B. Win loss ratio is just 3/10, but it is making more money than system B, and here win loss ratio is 8/10. So which one would you prefer? Will you prefer this or this? 3/10 is making more money, but here win loss ratio is very less, and here win loss ratio is more, but the money made is lesser than the first case. So even if it is offering you more money, this system is offering you more money, will you be comfortable to deploy system A? Will you be comfortable in deploying a strategy whose win loss ratio is just 3/10? You are losing most of the times and you are winning just 3 times out of 10. So will you be comfortable in deploying this system? Now the answer is up to you. So in a strategy, win loss ratio, it should be acceptable. It shouldn't be too high or it shouldn't be too less. The accuracy, even if the accuracy is too high, even if the accuracy is too high here, it doesn't mean that the win loss ratio is high. And here accuracy is very less, but win loss ratio is more. But will you be comfortable in deploying a system with a very less accuracy? Now let's come back to the slide and let's move ahead. Now we'll be discussing strategies of trading view. So these are the strategies that are present in the health manual as well. I'll show you where you can find them. So these strategies are only for educational purpose, and it is not any educational or financial advice for you. This is not a financial advice. There are a lot of strategies in TradingView. There are a lot of strategies available in TradingView. I can show you. There are a lot of strategies available in TradingView. But there are a lot of strategies. Around 100,000 plus strategies are available in TradingView. But these strategies are good enough to get you started with system trading or algo trading. The automated codes, the PineScript codes for these strategies are written in the help manual, and you can find it in the help manual. I'll show you where you can find it. Either you can go directly to the site, and if you want this to pop up, you have to go to API Bridge and click on help button here. When you click on the help button, the help manual will pop up. You have to go to TradingView connection. When you go to TradingView connection, you have to click on FAQs on TradingView Algo Trading. Now, if you have some questions related to TradingView, you can look for them here. Here are some frequently asked questions. And one of those questions is, can you give some good strategies with PineScript code? So yes, here we have given you some strategies with already written PineScript codes, which are set for automation. And they can work in full automation with TradingView. And I'll be deploying two of these strategies today. So before that, let's discuss these strategies. What are they offering? So first strategy is Supertrend. Then we have Bollinger Bands. Then Pivot Extension Strategy, Channel Breakout Strategy, RSI Strategy, MACD Strategy, Renko Strategy, Price Channel Strategy, RSI System Trading with Bracket Order, and NSE Options Trading Strategy. So let's define these strategies on the basis of these features here. First is minimum margin required. So you can see in all of these strategies, very less margin is required. And overnight risks are manageable for all of these strategies. All of these strategies are easy to execute. Backtesting metrics are available for all of these strategies, except for the last two strategies. You have to use them in paper trading or simulation mode. Then time frame for all of these strategies is 15 minutes or less. These all are intraday strategies, but some of them may have a good number of input parameters, so you can adjust them for positional trading as well. Strategy type. So this is one important feature here, which type of strategies it is. So if you are a momentum trader, you can go for momentum based strategies. If you like to trade in trend, then you can go on trend-based strategies. Some are mean reversion strategies. So it is one important feature, and we'll be discussing in coming slides on what basis you can select, on what order type is suitable for each type of strategy. So Supertrend is a trend without predefined strategy. Then Bollinger Bands is mean reversion. Pivot extension is mean reversion. Channel breakout is momentum. And similarly, others as well. Now, average number of trades in intraday. So all these strategies are offering you ample number of trades in intraday. There are not too high number of trades or not too less number of trades. So you can get started with them. Intraday or overnight, how you should prefer these strategies. So in Supertrend, you can prefer for intraday, Bollinger Band for intraday, Pivot Extension for intraday. Channel breakout strategy, you can go for both. RSI, intraday, MACD, and Renko strategy, you can go for both. Price channel strategy, both. RSI system trading with intraday, BO, you can go for intraday. And NSE option strategy, again, intraday. Now, the input parameters are also given here. So the strategy with good number of input parameters can be good, adjustable, and you can adjust them well for your positional trades as well. Now, this was the overview of the strategies, and I'll be deploying two of these strategies now. So the first strategy that I'm going to show you is NSE options algo strategy for TradingView. So let's come to the chart and finally see the practical part. I have already put this strategy here, but you can find this strategy in this help manual. On the seventh number, automatic strike calculation trading based on underlying price. When you click here, it will redirect you to this manual here. So you can find all the instructions related to this strategy. All the instructions how to put the strategy, what is the strategy premise, what is the logic of the strategy, and how it calculates the strike price, option strike price. This is an option strategy. So all the instructions are given here. You can see everything is given in detail, and all the parameters are also explained in detail. What kind of alert you should be putting here, and what are the settings in API Bridge that you would need. So all the instructions are given here. After the webinar is over, you can go and try it for yourself. So right now I'll be showing you how to put it on the chart. You just have to go to the indicators, search for NSE options algo strategy. So here Nifty options algo strategy is here, and it is uploaded by us in the public library. When you click on it, the strategy will appear on the chart. Now after you have put the strategy on the chart, what you have to do is you have to go at the bottom, click on settings here, on this settings button here, and adjust the parameters as per your requirement. So the default parameters will be RSI length would have been 14, upper band would be 80, and lower band would be 40. So I have already adjusted these parameters as per my requirement. What I wanted to show you a quick signal generation. I want to show you a demo of how this strategy works. So you shouldn't be repeating the parameters that I have put, because it is just for the demo purpose. I only wanted to show you quicker signal generation so that you can see how the strategy works. So I reduce the length of RSI to 4 so that I can see some quick signals. Then upper band is 70, lower band is 30. Now you have to define this intraday trade session. You have to enter the timing here, from what time to what time you want entry signals to get generated. So for example, if you are trading in MCX, you should expand this timing to around 11:30 or 11, whatever, for whatever time you want entry signals to get generated. Then in end session you will receive exit signals only. So you should adjust this parameter as per your requirement. For example, if you're trading in MCX, you should change it as per MCX only. So if you want exit signals only after 11, then you can change it from 2300 to 2345. And then you can change quantity from here, and all these input parameters you can change as per your requirement. I had already changed it as per my requirement, which is to show you how the strategy works. Now this is, I'm using 1 minute chart again to show you the quicker signal generation. After you are done adjusting the input parameters, you have to go to this more here, these three dots that were present in the tab. Then you have to click on add alert. When you click on add alert, remove the default message and go back to the help manual. In the help manual, you will find this instruction on how to set up alert. So you can see everything is mentioned here, and it is written that click in settings, add alert, paste this in message box. So you have to paste this message in the message box to set up alert for automation. Now if I'll paste it here and I'll click on create, my alert will be created. I have already created this alert, so I won't be clicking on create right now, but this is how you have to go about it. Now what does the strategy says? As per the strategy, what happens is, since it is an option strategy, so it places orders automatically in calls and puts. So I have selected Nifty here. But what happens is, whenever whenever RSI goes above 70, whenever RSI goes above 70, my long entry is created in a call. So you can see here my RSI went above 70 and a long signal was generated. I'm zooming into this so that it is more visible to you. Our long entry will be created in call, and if we already had a position in a put when market was falling, so first so that position will be exited as well. So along with the entry position in call, our exit signal was also sent for the put position that we already had. We already had a put position here. From here we had a put position, long and put. So when we got the entry signal for long in call, our position got exited in the put and our new position got created in the call. And how this works is, you have to, for example, today Nifty is trading around 11,900. So you have to add all the nearby strike prices in the watch list. For example, I've added 11,800 CETE, 11,900 CETE, and 12,000 CETE. So I have already added these strike prices in API Bridge. So you have to follow the same steps, and the same is mentioned in the help manual as well. So you have to add these strike prices here. So whenever a signal is received, API Bridge will place the order in the nearest strike price available. So API Bridge will place order in the nearest strike price available. So this is how the strategy works. And if you want to try this strategy, you just have to go to FAQs and click on 7th number, and you'll find all the instructions for this option strategy. And you can see, since I had already put up the strategy on the chart, it was running for quite some time. So I have received all these signals based on this strategy, and I am trading live in the market. So my positions can be seen here as well in the Zebul trading account. So these orders got rejected because I did not keep enough funds in the account. But whenever we receive the signal, our order gets placed. So this was all about NSE option algo strategy for TradingView. You can find it here and test it out for yourself. Here are more strategies which are mentioned in the tool comparison in the strategy sheet. I mentioned all these strategies in the sheet. So you can find these strategies here and test them out for yourself. Now the next strategy that I'll be discussing is Renko strategy. So today we'll be putting Renko strategy in live trading mode. Now I have already put this strategy in cloud, in the remote computer. While my NSE strategy was running in my local computer, I added this strategy in the cloud. You can see here, I have this remote computer cloud in which my strategy is already running. My Renko strategy is already running. Now to find this Renko strategy, you have to repeat the same steps. Go to TradingView connection and help manual. Go to FAQs on TradingView algo trading. And then you will find this Renko strategy here. On second number, you can find this Renko strategy. So what does this strategy say? I'll open its link. Wait. So this is the Renko strategy. So this, the limitations to advantages and the premise of this strategy are already mentioned in this document. You can read the instructions and you can apply this strategy as per the instructions given in this help manual. First, you have to download the PineScript algo to put the strategy on the chart. So copy the script, copy this PineScript, go back to the chart, add it in the Pine editor section. So you have to add this code here, then click on save and add it to the chart. These are just three steps, very easy steps that you have to do to add the strategy to your chart. Once you have added the strategy to your chart, you have to go to settings. After clicking on settings, you have to adjust the input parameters as per your requirement. So by default, here the value is 0. Here the value that you will see will be 0.45. But I wanted to show you a quicker signal generation. So for that purpose, I reduced the percentage of price here, and I am using one in the chart just so that we can get some quick signals. Then I adjusted. You can adjust these parameters as well. And then again, this is one important parameter, intraday trade session. For MCX, you'll have to change this parameter to around 10 or 11, whatever your requirement is. And you have to change this parameter as well. And you can choose the trade quantity. And then make sure that the symbol that you see here, for example, SBIN, the same symbol is available. You have put the same symbol in API Bridge watch list, and you have filled all the other parameters. All the other parameters, for example, entry order type and exit order type, and other symbol settings, you have already done. Once you have done this, click on Start Trading, and click on Start Trading, and then you have to create an alert. Signal generation from TradingView to API Bridge works on the basis of alert. So alert is one important step. Signals will go to API Bridge only when you have created an alert. So you have to add alert and follow the instructions given in this help manual. Then again, you have to paste this code for automation in the message box and click on create. So we just received a short entry signal, and we exited the long entry that the position that we already had. It got exited, and you can see type SE, our short entry also got created. And as we received the signal, the order was sent and it was placed. We are this is live market condition here. So this is where you will find this instructions regarding the strategy, how you have to put it, what is the strategy premise, what is the logic behind the strategy, what are the input parameters that you need to choose, and everything is mentioned here in the FAQs. Now I'll go back to my local computer, and this was how you have to put the Renko strategy. You can find it in the FAQs on TradingView. Now the last thing that we are going to discuss for the day, for this webinar, is order management settings for different strategies. Now you must be wondering why it is important, or even if you have a strategy, you want to put it out in the market, you must have thought at least once or twice which order type you should go for. So we'll be discussing it today, right now. let's come back to the slide. So for example, you can see I have mentioned strategy type here. Super trend is a trend without predefined price strategy. So we'll discuss what kind of order type you can prefer, what are the benefits and the problems associated with particular order types for these strategy types. So super trend is a trend without predefined strategy. So this is a table that I have created. Here you can see strategy types and the order types with their problems and benefits for a particular strategy type. So for example, we just saw that super trend is a strategy type of strategy of trend without predefined price. So let's discuss. So if we were to trade in super trend, if we were to use super trend strategy, so if we are using limit order for that particular strategy, what is the problem associated with it? We can miss the opportunity if limit order does not get filled. And there are less chances for that because market is in trend. So there are chances that market can come back to the limit price that we have mentioned. Then for market order says that we will not miss the opportunity. And then SLL order says we may miss the opportunity if the order does not get filled. And again, there are less chances for that. So for suppose you in SLL, you enter a trigger price and you order a price at which you want to execute the execute your order. So even if the trigger price gets hit and your order is sent, but there are chances that your order might not get filled. But in trend, there are less chances for that, but chances are still there. And if you are using SLM, in SLM, what you do is you enter a trigger price, and when the market hits trigger price, your order gets automatically executed at the best available price in the market. So if you will use SLM for this particular type of strategy, then you will not miss the opportunity. And for BO, the benefits are same with an additional benefit of stop loss and target. Now let's discuss momentum without predefined strategy. So what strategy it is? Channel breakout strategy. For example, you want to trade in channel breakout strategy, and it is momentum without predefined strategy. So this is a strategy type it falls in it into. So if you will be choosing limit order for such type of strategy, then again you can miss the opportunity if limit order does not get filled. So please notice here that market is in momentum. So there are very high chances that your order may not get filled because market is in momentum. There is speed in the market, and if you put a price lower than the market price, then there are chances that market would come back to that price and your order might not get filled. And then market, if you choose market order, then you will not miss the opportunity, but you can fall for slippage here because market is in momentum, and by the time your order will get executed, you will not know where the market will be. Then in SLL, you may miss the opportunity if order does not get filled. Market is in momentum, so there are more chances for your order not getting filled. In SLM, you will not miss the opportunity. Then let's discuss mean reversion without predefined price kind of strategy. For example, Bollinger Band. So for this type of strategy, mean reversion without predefined price, if we are using limit order, we can miss the opportunity if limit order does not get filled. In market order, we will not miss the opportunity. The benefit is that, and if we want to enter in market, so since in mean reversion strategy, what you generally do is you wait for the market to come down. So if you want to trade in market order, you'll have to wait for the market to come back to your price, and then you'll place the order. So you'll hear the problem is that you have to wait for that exact point where you want to create the entry. In SLL, you may not miss the opportunity if order, you may miss the opportunity if order does not get filled. And in SLM, you will not miss the opportunity. Then, what is the other? So these are the strategy types and these are the order types and the problems and the benefits associated with such strategies. So here, more strategy types are mentioned. For example, for no momentum with predefined price. So if there is a predefined price and there is no momentum in the market, so these are the problems and the benefits associated with particular order types. So think before you put a particular order type for the kind of strategy that you are trading in. You have to consider all these points. So this was all with the order types. Order management settings, basically order management settings for different types of strategies. Now, in the last, we'll discuss the whole algo setup, how you can get started. So the first thing that you'll have to do is, you'll have to sign up with TradingView. Then you have to create an account with API Bridge. You have to sign up with API Bridge. And then just go to this help manual. For the help manual, you just have to click on this help button. And go to this help manual. And you will find answers to most of your questions here. For example, if you click on FAQs on TradingView Algo Trading, so you will find all these strategies that we mentioned in this particular sheet here. And this was all with today's webinar. I hope this webinar was informative. And now, if you have any questions related to this particular webinar, related to what we discussed today, you can ask those questions.
You can ask the question through the chat box.
Ask the questions in the chat box. If you have any questions, please ask your questions in the chat box. To sign up for API Bridge, you can simply go here and click here, and you will be redirected to the sign up page. So you can first sign up for the paper trading mode or live trading mode, whatever is suitable for you, however you want to go about it. You have to create an account on TradingView. You have to sign up with API Bridge, and then this help manual is good enough for you to get going.
Already I have shared one link through the chat box. So this is a Zibu YouTube link. You can subscribe the channel and then you can get all notifications about the webinars and uploading of entire videos. You can access it. What are the doubts you have? You can directly access it. How to install the AlgoG and then how to test the backtesting. What are the strategies are there? Everything is there in that YouTube channel. Just subscribe and then get clicked. Thank you. Wish you care.
So even if you don't want to go for fine script coding, there are other ways you can find more links here. For example, how to use Trendline for algo trading in TradingView, or how to set up algo for candlestick patterns in TradingView. So there are more links available here. Or you can go for just how to set powerful algo alerts in TradingView. So you can also check out these links. But these are the already available PineScript strategies set up with automation. You can get started with them. You can test them out on paper trading mode. And you can at least get hands-on with how the whole algo trading works. So I've sent the I just sent the link to help manual in the chat box. You can contact Zebu support or Algorithm support and just sign up for the API bridge from here. I'm forwarding this link as well. You can sign up for API bridge from here if you already do not, if you already haven't signed up. In the next webinar, we will be discussing strategies for MetaTrader 4, and we'll be discussing some points on backtesting.